Well, this is why I love radio, because we can change gears in the middle of a thought. C4 joins us now on this
spontaneity
Thursday
is the word, Mr. Bill.
And I was going to talk to you about something completely different. And we walked into the studio, and you took off again on this woman who was riding her bicycle in Northern Virginia and flipped off the president's motorcade. And we got into it over your... You don't believe she was there by accident.
50-year-old Juli Briskman is her name. Just happened to be there as the president's motorcade went on. And by the way, this president has used this golf course more than President Obama ever did. Let's have another discussion of the criticism of how much President Obama golfed. But on a regular basis, he goes to this golf course. Mm-hmm. So for her to simply just be there, accidentally riding her bike with, by the way, somebody behind her ready to snap a picture. Because she didn't take the picture. Somebody, or a friend of hers behind her, snapped a picture, to which she very quickly uploaded this to her own site. Nobody did this for her. She uploaded it herself to her site. She goes on to do an interview with Katie Turr on MSNBC, where she talks about whatever job, because she got fired for this, whatever job I go to or cause I go to. I'm just adding 2 and 2 and getting 22, okay, Bill Vanko?
You don't trust anybody.
I do, but I do get, I have a people call it a perpetrator gene. I have a gene that seems to sniff out perpetrators when it comes to their just happening to coincidentally, accidentally, whatever you want to say, be there. I don't believe it
at all.
You don't
think she was just out for a ride on a nice day?
Oh, I believe she rides.
Motorcade came by and she just took the opportunity to express her First Amendment rights.
Nope. And also, you know, somebody who's only been working someplace for 6.5 months, I could see a 21-year-old maybe do it, but somebody who's 50, you would think they would know if they uploaded something like this to a government contractor, is who she works for, a government contractor.
Yeah, that was the part
that might have negative consequences at the end of that story. That story doesn't end well, okay?
If you work for a government contractor and you flip off the big boss.
Thank you. Now, let me ask another question, Bill. If you don't think that this is somehow maybe orchestrated, look at the attention that she's getting for this. And look at now the nationalization of Juli Briskman. We're talking about it. I'm sure others are. I'm sure that's all coincidental.
I liked it so much more when it was, just a
don't good, a good look little... at the man behind the curtain.
Yeah, there we go. Okay. Well, now we've talked about that.
Yes, we did.
How about your show last night? You had a special show last night to sort of mark 1 year since Donald Trump.
Technically, we weren't 1 year because he really didn't make the speech until 3 a.m. to November 9th, but 1 year later. And really, the biggest thing that came out from last night, Bill Vanko, a lot of people, you know, have been surprised, we all have, by this president. It doesn't even seem like it's been a year since the election. The biggest thing that came out, though, is I thought more people would be upset if tax reform, the one thing that Republicans run on, the one thing this president really talked about, if that doesn't go through. And people who voted for Trump, who were in the audience last night, really, that's not the biggest thing to them. Healthcare and some of the other things that are more personal are more important to them. It just, that was one of the issues that came as a surprise to me.
The people who voted for Trump a year later.
Yes.
Can you ballpark what they think of him?
He walks on water. He's the greatest thing that's ever happened. They enjoy. Look, if you look at that 35-37% that he holds on to, I mean, consistently.
That hasn't changed. There's that one third of the American public.
But those are his voters that are going to defend him here and there. Now, President Trump won. I keep reminding people, President Trump won the election with 200 counties across the Midwest of this country, Pennsylvania, Wisconsin, Michigan, Ohio, Indiana, that all these 200 counties twice voted for President Obama. This time they voted for President Trump. Think about that. Majority Democratic counties. Mm-hmm. Twice they voted for Obama. This time they voted for Trump. I don't believe they're going to be there next time. Now, that's C4 saying it. But that 35-37%, they're going to be there if he does shoot somebody in Central Park, as he said, and he can get away with it. They're going to be there regardless.
It's going to take 3 years to find out.
But everyone, thank everybody for coming out last night. It was a great town hall forum.
Absolutely. C4 heard Monday through Friday from 9
to 1.
Don't
flip the bird, Mr. Bill.
I will not do that.
All right.
My hands right here on the desk. And you can see us on YouTube on the WBAL channel as well. C4 Monday through Friday from 9 to 1 on WBAL News Radio 1090.